Alrighty, get to be on the play here. Probably gonna draw island, island. Can't cast anything. Alright, this hand seems fine. It's not insane. I mean, I wish it had one less land, I guess, like minus a taiga plus a spell, but still it has turn one elves and it has strip mine to delay the opponent. And it has a castable Mystic Snake, so I think given that it's got ramp, a card that's gonna be basically a time walk and Mystic Snake, it seems like it's worth it. All right, let's just go. Let's see. Is there a reason to play Taiga here? I do not believe there is, since Steam Mints is a land I'm going to be putting a high priority on playing at some point, so might as well do that. Ooh, Explore is nice. Let's strip mine the island. Do this so I can't get force spiked, and then play Steam Vents. All right, drawing the Flooded Grove was bad, but drawing Explore was good. If I can draw a threat here. Well, I'm not gonna keep Mystic Snake up. I feel like the odds that my opponent plays something turn two that I really care about is kind of low, and playing and not attacking with Lanerils makes it so obvious that I have Mystic Snake. Grim Monolith. Well, I actually don't know if I would want to Mystic Snake that. Just because I'd rather counter the thing that comes off it. And I'm definitely keeping Mystic Snake up now since my opponent's got a Grim Monolith and, well, he's hopefully gonna use it to cast something insanely large. No, tap the Grim Monolith. Oh yes, there we go. Don't have a counterspell backup. Oh yeah, that's getting definitely snaked. And then I will go ahead and play Trade and Rider and hopefully lock my opponent. Hopefully I don't get Supreme Verdicted this turn. That would be kind of unfortunate. Ooh, Plowunder. Well, I actually like just playing Plowunder here. Let's get those lands at random. I guess it doesn't really matter too much given that my opponent's got a Mystic Gate. It doesn't matter which lands I choose. And smash for three. Pass the turn. So the reason I plow under instead of playing Trade and Rider is if my opponent does have something like Wrath, this gives me a lot more hits, and if they don't have Wrath, then getting the Trade and Rider out is going to be fine when it gets out. Alright, let's hit. The question now is whether I play a Wall of Roots. Unfortunately, Spellskite is going to stop Trade and Rider from being too awesome. I don't think I'm going to play the wall because I don't really need to. Like, I can cast Cord, I can cast Sundering Titan, I can cast all the expensive spells I have in my deck. So, hopefully, this ends up working out. Unfortunately, again, Spellskite's going to stop me from doing like Trade and Rider, bounce my Mystic Snake, fully lock my opponent. But if that is not the case, we'll see. See, this lets me play around Wrath too. I mean, I guess Supreme Verdict's uncounterable, but had my opponent had a Supreme Verdict, I got to have the Mystic Snake lock up before that happens. Looks like I'm citing an Ancient Grudge here, though. All right, let's just pass the turn. There's no point in bouncing anything with Trade and Rider. I'd rather bounce Spellskite end of turn so my opponent cannot recast it. And I don't really want to play a wall into a Wrath, like I said before. What's my opponent casting during my second main phase here? For triple blue, Vendilion Click. Okay, well, still my main phase, but that's fine. Alright, opponent clicking himself, which makes sense considering if I had something good, I probably would have cast it. Revealing Coral Helm Commander. Well, I like that I'm playing against like the creature version of blue white rather than a more controller version. I mean, I assume my opponent doesn't have too many Wraths. Could still have Wrath in the deck very easily, but it probably doesn't have one in hand if Vendilion Click and Spellskite are getting out there. End of turn. Let's just bounce Mystic Snake. If my opponent wants to redirect it, they can pay some life for some mana. And if Mystic Snake gets bounced successfully, then I'll be happy. Alright. Well, in that case, because now I can just play Wall of Roots and still have Mystic Snake and Trade and Rider up. Let's just pass. I could bounce the Spellskite and then Mystic Snake it when it gets cast, but again, no real reason to do that. Since it doesn't let me keep Trade and Rider up or Mystic Snake up, I can just bounce Spellskite end of turn instead. That seems a lot stronger, and if my opponent has like a Supreme Verdict, then at least now I don't get destroyed by it. Alright, so now I'm just bouncing the Spellskite, since there's nothing else my opponent has that I really feel like I have to bounce. So I'd rather take the option of Spellskite away from my opponent. And I have a Mystic Snake at the ready here. Ooh, a Green Sun Zenith. So I want to keep Mystic Snake mana up, so I can essentially Green Sun Zenith for five, No, six even, because I have Wall of Roots. So I could get a Deranged Hermit. Could get an Avenger of Zendikar, but I don't think I want to risk that. So let's pay that. Could get a Bloodbraid Elf. What does that get me? That gets me potentially a Shardless Agent or a Mana Ramp spell. Also, Bloodbraid Elf plus Treadnought is good, but so is Deranged Hermit. So let's just get a Deranged Hermit, I think. I would rather just go off with that if I can. Also, I guess I could Bloodbraid into a Green Sun Zenith, which I don't really like. So, Deranged Hermit seems like the play here. Now we'll pass the turn. I've got Mystic Snake at the ready. If my opponent plays a Spellskite, do I Mystic Snake it? Probably, because then I can just bounce the Mystic Snake end of turn instead of doing anything else. Ooh, what does my opponent have? Untapping Grim Monolith. All right. Well, I actually maybe I should save Mystic Snake for something my opponent monoliths out. I mean, something like Rout would be annoying. Though the Green Sun Zenith in my deck is another reason to play Spells or Apocrisite because it reduces the odds that I cascade into Green Sun Zenith. So that's actually something worth thinking about. See what my opponent is up to here. Tapping the Grim Monolith, maybe leading with a Spellskite. You know, I actually think I let Spellskite happen. Just because this game's gonna be over pretty soon, so if my opponent just casts Spellskite over and over again, that's not a big deal. The Goose of Saint Traft. So I can Mystic Snake that. I don't care about Geist very much. I think I would rather just let that resolve. Geist doesn't seem like it does anything here. My opponent plays a Spellskite, then I will counter it. Let's see what my opponent's playing for four. Untapping Grim Monolith, okay. Passing the turn. Well, let's just trade and ride the Grim Monolith then, since I think that's best. Then I'll just pay for the Hermit and then attack. I mean, I could have bounced my Hermit instead, but I don't really need to cast anything else here. And it seems like I'm going to kill my opponent in two hits regardless with these squirrels, so I don't really need to worry too much. If my opponent does too much blocking, then maybe I gave my opponent an extra turn here, but I think this is fine. Let's see, I can attack for nine with the snake. That's not quite enough. Now, if my opponent casts Grim Monolith, that I will counter with Mystic Snake, since that caps my opponent from being able to play anything but like a Spellskite or something equally lame. Don't have quite enough mana to Spellskite first. Yeah, that's fine. I'll snake that now. Boop. And don't have quite enough mana to be able to snake twice. I guess if I had paid with Wall of Roots, I would. And then my opponent plays a Grim Monolith here. I'm probably just bouncing it. Don't need to do anything else. Actually, let's just bounce. Do I want to bounce that or Mystic Snake? Actually, let's bounce the Grim Monolith. The reason I'm doing that is that I'm only going to need to snake one more time here, so I don't really need to try to get value. And this way, my opponent has less mana to work with. Courser of Kruphix. Doesn't do a whole lot for me. Since I get to attack my opponent, actually, I can attack with Lunar Elves here. Let's not attack with the Elf. I think that the most likely way I lose here is like the actual card Supreme Verdict, so I'll just keep Courser in hand in case that happens. And if my opponent does have Supreme Verdict, then I'll just bounce the Deranged Hermit with Trade and Rider, and then next turn I'll have an instant army as well. Opponent's got a Grim Monolith in hand, plus who knows what else. This Mystic Snake did some work this game, countered a Future Sight, and I guess a Spellskite. Just those two, but the threat of Mystic Snake did a lot. Is this the actual Supreme Verdict? That would be kind of annoying. Nope, it is not. Is my opponent pretending like they have it? I think I like Grudge over Nature's Claim, though this actually kills a Future Sight as well. I don't know if I'm gonna want both. I could play Beast Within instead. Maybe I take out Apocrisite. Though Apocrisite's kind of nice. Treachery actually looks kind of bad. I have not seen a good target for Treachery. Let's take out Treachery. Maybe I could take out an island too, or maybe not. Man, Bloodbraid Elf has some misses actually with the Green Suns and the Cord. That's all right. I have no fear. And I guess I could take out Obstinate Bailiff. This doesn't look like an Obstinate Bailiff matchup to me.